Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity, as brought to you by my amazing supporters over on Patreon, as per usual. We're just jumping on in here, and we have two plans of attack. Well, two points of attack, I should say. We can go to the lower ramparts, or the kitchen. I'm torn. I would think that the kitchen would probably be less defended than the ramparts. So, eh.
Right.
Yeah, I think we're gonna go for the kitchen. I'm a coward. I wanna do this as easily as possible, I guess. Run to my little minions. The speed button is probably one of the better additions they made here. So let's go upstairs. If you gained access to the stronghold, you can access it at any time from the central HUD. We have figured that out. I actually got one as I was loading into the game for this session that said, apparently when we have a prison in our keep, we'll be able to take people prisoner, certain people prisoner. So that's interesting. Alright, so, it's probably not wise to just be wandering around here with the entire group, so I think I'm gonna have Goldleaf go all sneaky sneak and see if she can't find anything.
What?
I'm sure there's probably just food. Yeah. Some vegetables. Up here, roast goat smells only faintly of smoke and burnt fat. Hunks of meat have been carved from the cold carcass. Goat is decent. If you like lamb, goat is similar. It's a little different, but it's similar. Okay. I'm just waiting to like turn a corner and there's gonna be like 50 guys. Okay, we have a Raidric guard. Two Raidric. Oh no, no! Oh shit! The fight is on! Run, Goldleaf, run! Alright, so she's running. You guys move to intercept. You move to intercept. Goldleaf, you just keeping on. And that this is an AoE, I can't have it lock target onto her, so that's less than ideal. Okay, so she can stand actually right here. I'm just gonna have her do Holy Radiance. Get off of my freaking cleric. Switch over to melee and give this guy a bad day. Okay. So she's out of the fray. That's the primary. I think she's out of the fray. I don't think she's actually out of the fray. Let's see about maybe paralyzing this asshole before he drops her. Nope. I mean, he's paralyzed now, naturally. But not before Goldleaf goes down. Alright, get your gun back out. And I guess, like, it's a total waste to summon skeletons now, so I'm not even gonna have him bother. Alright, by the time he's done reloading, everybody else is gibbed.
Yeah.
Nicely done, Goldleaf. You played your part terribly, as per protocol. And we don't really have anything I care about here, so we're just gonna stash all that. What do we have here? More of the same. Oh, so she's got a wound of some sort here that is maybe reducing her max health. Nice.
What?
Well, thankfully, we have treat wounds, though. Field triage, rather. Let's see how this does. There we go. Alright, so we'll just have them use both of them on her, because she's really the only one that's, like, heavily injured. I mean, our bard, Chanter, I can never remember his name, Kana, is wounded, but not too badly. Alright, well in this case, I guess we're just gonna go full on violence, massacre through this place, and kill everyone that gets in our way. Silver forks and knives are gnawed with tarnish. We have cell swords, sure. See where the battle starts. This is a fight. Alright, can I just right there? This looks effective. Oh, let's get some heals flowing out here from both of these guys, I think, cause Adair is getting the crap kicked out of him. And once again, Goldleaf is getting ganked. You guys. What is this? Jesus, the entire party just focused that dude down. He got boned pretty hard. This archer. Stop standing the bad guys. Come on now.
Yes?
You guys. There we go. Say, quit standing in the bad. Alright, what do we have? Looks like just a bunch. Wow, a lot of money. There it goes. How interesting the game, like, there was so much loot for it to go through that it took a second and had to think about it. I want to check really quick. Eventually. How much money do we have? 1,400. Nice. I think that means that we can afford. Or did I already grab the thing that was 1,400? I think I might have already grabbed it. Yeah, main keep. Okay. Wow, we have made a lot of money since we came in here then. Holy crap. Take this. Ooh. Ah, lootables. A hatchet. And a floppy hat. And some armor that I'm probably just gonna vendor. And that's another thing, is we're getting all this money just in coins, and that's not even including all the stuff that we're gonna get from selling stuff. The joints are fringed with rust. The emblem of the breastplate is a tree with broad heart-shaped leaves. Okay.
Let's go!
Lava!
Oh, we got a mage. Aloth, why don't you circle around and give the mage some. Don't stand in the bad, guys. Oh, that was not bad, apparently. Okay. Swell's getting beat on here a little bit. Why don't you just lay on hands yourself? There. Problem solved.
All right, then.
All right, some junk. And what do we have here? A Spellwright's Tome, Fine Robes. All right, so this is going to be some stuff that's going to a loth, I think. What is this? A wand. All right. Cape hood and some coins.
Yes.
So let's see what we have here. A fine robe. Which I'm tempted to give him. I think I am going to give him instead of his padded armor because I would rather he be able to recover more quickly, because honestly, he hasn't really been getting attacked at all. So we have in here Rolling Flame, Council Hots, Corrosive Siphon, and Miasma of Dullinitis. This is, I think, maybe some of what we should take our money towards. Like, I know I have one tome. Let's see, we're gonna learn Fireball. And I think I have one on him, yeah, that has both Fireball and Lightning Bolt, and we're gonna have him learn that as well. Inflicts corrosive damage, converting that essence into endurance. So this is like kind of a life leech. That's kind of meh. We'll work against the elements. Thrust of Tattered Veils. Disrupts enemy spellcasters. All right. Yes. I think that's really about it. So then, let me know in the comments, does he really even, outside of memorizing the spells, should I really even keep these on his quick slots? Because it seemed that when I swapped to one of them to cast spells from it, he couldn't actually cast the spells that were in it unless he had them memorized. So, like, in that case, well, okay, so maybe he can only cast them if he owns them. So in that case, it would benefit me having multiple spellbooks, because then I could have, like, this is his damage over time spellbook and stuff like that. Okay, so in that case, yeah, I think I am going to hold on to these guys. And I can just switch to them when I need him to use them. But for the time being, see, I'm going to get rid of Wizard's Double and replace that with my anti-spellcaster spell here. Let's see, corrode damage, how much is it? 200, sure. I'm just learning this so that he has an extra fourth level or second level spell. I'm really not too interested in Bulwark Against the Elements.
I shall.
Okay. So we have a door there that I have a feeling probably leads to nothing good. Oh.
Huh?
Gold Leaf, can you do this? You can't even do this. I think her mechanics is only 6, isn't it? Yeah. Huh. Damn. All right.
How bad?
Everybody else looking on levels here. Getting there. Slowly but surely. I think we're gonna come down this way. It's gonna poke around a little bit. Dead ends. Oh, hey guys. Let's see, who is this swell? There's our. All right, so we're actually in a pretty good position here. And this is looking pretty straightforward, so I don't think we're gonna really need to do too much. Just let my guys, you know, hack their way through these guards. Nice. 29 damage with the musket shot. Oh, there's more. What do we have? Sellsword, a priestess. All right. So what? Oh, he doesn't even have any. Okay, so the range on this is pretty short, so I'm gonna have to keep that in mind. Here, I'm gonna nail her with a necrotic lance as quickly as I can. That was disappointing. But it is what it is, I suppose. He's not even gonna have time to chant, I don't think, for his third level. Well, maybe he will, okay. There's one guy left. No, that's his Fusro Da. Alright, here we go. Let's explode some downed enemies. I think that worked. Maybe. I don't know. Okay, some general junk we will take. And we have chests. And chests mean possible traps. I keep forgetting, I'm used to, like, in Baldur's Gate, where, like, the sneak icon is in with all of their abilities and stuff, so that's why I keep sending my mouse to find it. I'm just gonna have her do a quick circuit here. 132 coins and a Morning Star. We're already making back some of what we spent. We're down to 750. I blew about half of my money, well, more than half of my money, on purchasing spells, I guess, so I'm okay with it because we needed to do it. So, and it's not like we really have anything to spend the money on anyways at this specific moment in time. Fine scale mail, fine mail armor. I'm gonna go ahead and throw that into Swell's inventory just so that we can compare it really quick. What is this, 11 and 45? Let's see, 7 and 35. And I think those are, yes. So we will give that to Kana. I can go into the stash along with most of this other stuff. I'm gonna go ahead and throw this on here. This is what, Rolling Flame? Yeah, I'm gonna actually probably the next fight that I can use that in reasonably. I think we're gonna use that just to see how it kind of works. Under the pillow is a wooden medallion carved with a rising sun and three stars. It is tied to a leather thong. Okay. And you guys, just vendor trash, essentially. Okay. I don't know, I'm two minds. I'm of two minds with regards to the transferring stuff to stash. Like, I like it because I can be an absolute whore and take all of the loot, but I don't like it because I remember, you know, playing back in the days of Baldur's Gate, that some of the tougher choices in dungeons, you know, you get into this massive delve, and you've got to make the choice. It's like, do I want to take all this stuff, or do I want to go back to town, sell stuff, and come back, or keep, you know, pushing forward? Oh man, that dude paralyzed Adair in like the perfect place. Swell is getting the hell beaten out of him. I'm gonna have him heal himself. Loth is out of spells. I can just drop a heal, I guess. He should be getting another one. I was gonna say shortly. Okay, so these are just cell swords and guards. All right, not a problem. What we have in here, a couple things and a mound of bodies. Look at all that. I don't know. Like, we have here a fine spear and a scepter. I'm not gonna use either of those. The way I would kind of, I guess, balance that is essentially just make. Like, if you're gonna let the player take all of the loot, you've gotta make it so that your general, like, you know, your mundane stuff, like swords and whatnot, aren't worth a ton of money. All right, so I'm gonna take this, and I'm gonna hold on to this, just in case we need it. I'm not gonna read it, because I don't wanna be reading books in the middle of a Let's Play here. It takes a while. But I wanna carry it, just in case. Oh, this is bad, I'm running. We're under attack! Yes, you are. And the people attacking you need to rest. And you'll know that I've got, ouch. I've got Kana going into melee. I'm gonna try him in melee for a little while just to kind of see how he runs, whether or not it's worth it. Oh, another Spellwright's Tome. I'm just gonna, I'm gonna give that one to Aloth as well. I don't know if it's gonna actually be any different spell-wise. Okay, where's the other one? No, all right. So that means I can just throw that in the stash to be sold. But as I was saying, just kind of make it so that, you know, basic swords and stuff, since you're gonna be getting a ton of them, are only worth like a couple gold pieces or copper pieces or whatever your game's base currency is. And then you can still have players that, you know, loot everything, but, you know, it's really in the long term, you know, you have to sell 50 swords to get something of the value of like one minorly magical sword or something. Nice pathfinding there, Adair. Really impressed. Getting stuck on a pillar. All right, so I saw another guy up here, which, assuming it's only one, how are our clerics looking? Huh? Our clerics both actually have a decent complement of spells. Paladin of Brath. All right. Well, I mean, we can quick save, which is what I'm gonna do. Just the one paladin? No, two paladins of Brath. Okay, well, let us get a blessing down. I assume that they'll engage somewhere close to the center here. And I'm gonna do Barbs of Condemnation on one of them. And I'm gonna focus fire on this guy. And see. Let's see, do I have anything? Consecrated ground, long lasting circle of healing. Yes. No. Get up here. Out there, do that. Some heal over time effects going on here. These guys are pretty tough. They've got some hit points and they've got the self-healing abilities. I mean, they are still paladins. And you know, we have this. How does this work? Oh. Who's gonna soak the hit? I think I can do that with just a dare, maybe? Swell's gonna soak it, all right. Oh, and they bounce! Oh my god, that could lead to some horrible situations. I am reminded of lightning bolts in, like, the old gold box games, where you'd bounce them off a wall, and because video game, they'd bounce weird and kill half your party. Good times. So what do we got here? Some plate armor, full helms, capes, and greatswords. That's nothing I'm actually interested in. And can we rest here? Yes, because we need to rest bad. I want a dream. Okay, we see green things, guys. We see green things. Nothing in here? No, nothing beyond the door that is also locked. Foiled. All right, what do we have here? Aha! Okay. Got a bunch of stuff in here. Possible loot. Drains your fringes rust. Yep, same thing as the other one. Let's go ahead and grab what loot we got here. Potion of Wizards double we will give to Aloth. We'll take that. All right, another book. And another book. Were I playing this on my own, I would probably be reading these, but like I said, I don't want to spend 5 minutes reading a book for you guys. Let's see, a compilation. Nope, different books. All right, making sure. Map. Well, crap. It looks like, I mean, obvious secret door notwithstanding. Oh, nice! Goldleaf did her freaking duty as a kind of sneaky person. Good job, Goldleaf. Okay, go into sneak mode. Just to detect traps. What do we have here? Potion of Merciless Gaze. 15% of hits converted to crits. I'm going to actually give that to Adair. And we have here a pistol, a hatchet, and some coins. And a lock that she is going to be able to effortlessly pick with a belt of bountiful healing. And throw that in our inventory. We'll sort gear out here in a moment. Dusty old ledgers record the taxes paid to farmsteads in Gilded Vale as far back as 2632. Okay. So a belt of bountiful healing, plus 25% healing received, I think. Yes, all right, so he's got the amulet, so I'm actually gonna give this to Adair.
Hmm.
So there, now both of my frontliners are receiving some superior healing numbers. Oh, this, oh God, what is this? Blood still runs wet from the woman's slit throat, soaking into the sheets below. So is this the dude's wife then? Blackened pages curl in the fire, a leather cover embossed with rising sun and three stars is barely visible through the flames. Oh, you guys, why would you do that? You're terrible. What do we get? Rimran's mantle. All right, I assume that's a cloak, a clothes. So what's wrong with you guys? What is your boggles? Severe burns. Pretty much across the board. Nice, guys. Esports. That's what I get for not checking out for traps. It's my own damn fault. So what's this thing do? Damage reduction against freeze and 20% of freeze damage converted to endurance. So then what does freeze damage normally bypass endurance? Perhaps. I do not know. Okay. One more room. This looks like, no. All right, I'm gonna close this and we're gonna call it here because this looks like it's gonna take us into this next area. And I don't want this to end up being like a 35 minute episode because I have a feeling that's what's gonna happen. Anyways, I'm calling it. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time and I will catch you all next time where the adventure continues. Until then.